Before I had surgery, I was experiencing a lot of tiresome. I couldn't do anything, lazy all the time, out of breath before surgery, all this had happened. Okay, since I got the job, I'm able to walk, stand on my own, climb a few stairs. I couldn't do that before the surgery. And I'm taking it one day at a time to get better.
Hi, Mr. Brooks, how are you doing?
Doctor, how are you doing?
Okay, you feeling well?
Mr. Brooks is doing very well with the Jarvik device. His progress is appropriate. He was very sick before the device, so he has improved remarkably since the device was put in. Before he got the pump, he was very short of breath. He had a lot of swelling in his lower legs and really couldn't do much because of fatigue, could not move around. So now he's able to move in at home. He's able to go up a flight of stairs. He lives in a two-story home, and he's able to really walk as much as he wants inside the house.
And what's most novel about this particular pump is the design of the electrical cable. And this is the pump. The pump is placed inside the main pumping chamber of the heart. So it goes inside the left ventricle. And then the blood goes into the pump. The pump is powered by its electrical cord. And then the blood comes out what's called a graft. And that graft connects to the main blood vessel that leads out of the heart. So the blood goes into the pump and it goes out the graft. And through the blood coming through the graft, it is supplying the patient with enough blood where their heart couldn't do before. Now, to power this pump, this electrical cable has to be plugged in. It's plugged into batteries. In most people, in previous generations of pumps, this electrical cable has come out through the abdomen or through side of the chest. And what we have seen in many of those patients is that they can develop a propensity for an infection where the electrical cable exits the body. The advantage of this electrical cable is that it's tunneled through the chest, up the neck, and we place it behind the ear. And what we do is there's a series of holes on it, and we actually physically screw it into part of the skull. So it's fixed very securely, doesn't move. And then the skull and the skin around the skull are very, have a great supply of blood. They're very rich. The blood supply to the scalp is rich. And because of that rich blood supply, we believe that the propensity for infection may be less. Now, this pump is still investigational. It's part of an FDA study, as well as the technique of this driveline implantation. So we don't know with certainty. And Mr. Brooks is part of that evaluation. So we're very cautiously watching him to see long-term how this type of electrical connection will work for many years to come.
Dr. Jarvik has really single-handedly been instrumental in designing artificial hearts and is also involved in helping us. Because it's totally implantable, the patients can swim and shower because there's no external cord.